Would you keep a lion as a pet in your home?
What? A lion as a pet? No. Why would I do that?
Would you keep a lion as a pet in your home?
A lion? If it's a pet, if it's tiny, yeah. If it's like a newborn.
No, of course not.
No, I wouldn't. I don't like pets at all.
Actually, no.
Yes.
That's a trick question.
Would you keep a chimpanzee as a pet in your home?
Yeah. Yeah, I think so.
Probably not.
No, of course. Of course I won't.
No.
Actually, yeah, I would.
No, I don't think I wouldn't keep.
No.
Because it moves a lot and I can't control it.
I don't know, it's different. It's different.
I won't feel safe. It's an animal that should live in the jungle or whatever, in its natural area, natural environment.
Because I can show off and it's fancy and it's nice.
I really think that having a lion would be cool.
Because I don't think I'd be able to provide for it as much as the wild could provide for it.
I feel like they are humans, you know? You can't take them with you. I've seen so many videos before, and the way they act, the way they live with people, and yeah, it's really great.
أنا اسمي عبد الرحمن أحب الحيوانات بس مو بكل الحيوانات أحب الحيوانات الغريبة واللي مو موجودة في كل مكان ما أحب الحيوانات العادية لأن كل حد عنده وأنا بجرب أربي شيء جديد فأخذ الأشياء الغريبة واللي مو موجودة عند كل حد
بنت جديدة
عندي شمبانزي عندي بوما وعندنا أسود ونمور ووايد من هالحيوانات المفترسة.
Hi, my name is Khaled bin Sultan bin Khaled bin Sultan Al Qasmi. I'm an Emirati and I live with a lot of animals. Over here we have three adult oryx and one baby newborn oryx. We have a bunch of gazelles and some chickens. We have pheasants and three cats.
نحن نشتري تقريبا معظم حيواناتنا من ربيعنا اللي هو أمازون بيت وهم يأخذونهم من أفريقيا من الأماكن النائية والأماكن اللي مو معتنين فيهم فهم يأخذونهم يبون هالحيوانات لنا عقب نحن نشتريهم تقريبا ونحاول كثر ما نقدر نعتني فيهم أكثر من ما هم كانوا يعتنون فيهم
My father got the oryx and the gazelles from a friend of his who managed to get these animals from a reserve that was overflowing with animals because the gazelles and the oryx were breeding very well. So the reserves were built because long ago oryx and gazelles used to be native to the UAE and they became extinct here in this country. Due to hunting and due to hunting. So the UAE imported some Arabian oryx and some gazelles and other animals from Africa and repopulated them within the country. And after the overflow in the reserves, they started donating them to other countries that had lost their wildlife.
My name is Laura Glanfield. I've been in the UAE about 19 years now. I run a boarding kennels and a cattery. And about 5 years ago, we set up an animal sanctuary and petting farm in the view of providing a place where people can interact with animals and try to learn a little bit more how to care for animals. You tend to find tortoises wandering around down the street, rabbits, injured birds, so African greys flown into my balcony. I don't know what to do. I've got a baboon sitting in my garden. I don't know where it's come from. We've had that twice now. Snakes we've had calls for, but they tend to be the ones from the wild and pretty dangerous. Flamingos we've had, a lady with flamingos, six flamingos, but her dog attacked them. So I was looking for a place, but we didn't keep them because my place isn't suitable, but I know somebody who has a great place for flamingos where they're well looked after. He would usually contact us and say, we've got these animals, do you have a place for them? Can you take them? We're leaving the country, we can't take them with us. The same with we have giant tortoise. People can't take them with them. And they've obviously been in this country from a small age. They've grown, and now they're like 60, 70 kilos, and to carry one onto a pay cargo on an aircraft is very expensive. So they tend to pass them on, and we feed them, we take care of them.
تقريبا قبل ما نجيب اي حيوان في البيت نخبر في البيت انه بنجيب مثلا هالحيوان عشان يتهيئون نفسيا يوم يشوفونه ما يصدمون وقبل ما نجيبهم نسوي لهم تحاليل ونطعمهم عشان لا سمح الله يعني يمكن يكون في هالحيوان فيروس ولا شيء يعني ينقل العدوى حقنا نحن عشان نكون مثل ما يقولون في الامان
A lot of people go buy these small baboons. I have no idea where they come from, who buys them, but people buy them, and I think they're on sale for like 1,500 dirhams. You could buy a small baboon. These baboons carry the same diseases as children. So if you've got young children in your house, why are you bringing a baby baboon that you don't really know where it's come from into your home with your family?
عامل جورج وفلا كانهم أطفال صغار عادي أسدحهم مثل ما تشوفون وأبدل البامبرز والقميص والبنطلون عادي أما مانش يعني أنظف فراء عادي أخلي أي حد ينظف وأكلهم جورج وفلا أكلهم أكل عادي أكلنا نحن ومانش أكل لحم ني أو دياي ني صفاتهم أو مثل ما نقول شخصياتهم جورج كان ياهل كله يحب يتعلق في الناس وبس ذكي ومانش تقريبا من أذكى الطيور لأنه يعني إذا طلعته وبغيت أدخله وهو ما يبغى يدخل يشرد يعني يحاول يسوي يشرد عني بأي طريقة وفلة يعني ذكية بس أقل وحدة يعني تكون ويا الناس من بين هالثلاث حيوانات
We take care of the oryx and gazelles by keeping them in a pen outside. Even though the temperature does get a bit too hot over here, we built a shade over the pen so they could escape the heat. We feed them a diet of hay, vegetables, and supplements so that they get receive the nutrients they require.
تقريباً أي حيوان في العالم مهما كان خطير إذا ربيته من هو صغير وتعود عليك في نسبة ضعيفة جدا أنه مثلا يجرب عليك أو يأذيك وبالنسبة للأسود والنمور نحن ناخذ نقص أظافرهم يعني وأنيابهم أما للشمبانزي ما نسوي أي شيء ولا نقص رؤوسهم ولا شيء مثلا الشمبانزي يعني ما حد يعرف كيف تكون يعني the next move يعني كيف من وين بيك وهذا اما النمر او الاسد يعني ما يقدر يسوي شيء يعني يا بينقز عليك يا بي من وراك هاي الاشياء شو اسمه متوقع بس الشمبانزي مثلا اذا عصب ولا شيء بس يعني نخليه بروحه خليه يسوي ليبا وعقب ما نرد له عادي فبيكون
I wouldn't play with the oryx or gazelles like I would play with my cats. They're not as friendly. They're more protective of themselves and each other. Especially the female oryx that gave birth. She's very protective of her child. She even attacks the other oryx that come close to her newborn.
مرة يعني كنا طالعين ويا واحد من ربعي هو عنده شمبانزي بس يعني وايد أكبر عن جورج وكنا طالعين عادي كل شيء تمام وهذا يوم رقد أنا كنت ياسا حذالة فواحد من ربعي بغى يلعوزي يعني تم يقرقطه ويفر عليه الشنطة فعصب فما قدر يوصل حق ربيعي فتم يضربني أنا بس هو شو يعني يعرف أن نحن ما بنأذيه فإذا صدق يعني يبا يذبحني كان كلاني لأن أنيابه كانت وايد طويلة بس هو كان بيضربني بس بإيده بس ضرباته كانت قوية الرسالة اللي أبغى أوصلها حق الناس اللي مثلا يبون يأخذون مثلا الحيوانات بس مترددين أقول لهم لا تترددون لأن يعني إذا أنت تبغى شيء خذه بس خذه وهو صغير يعني لا تأخذ مثلا شمبانزي عود عقب يعني هو بيتصرف يسوي أشياء أنت بتخليك تكره الحيوان فخذ الشيء من هو صغير عشان يتعلم عليه وياك يعني وعليك ويعرفك ف جسمه تكون عقب تعرف شو الأشياء اللي يسويها غلط تقدر تعلمه وشو الأشياء اللي يسويها صح وتعطيه تكافئ وشي.
So it's a very sensitive issue, and a lot of questions can be asked, and a lot of ideas can be put forward. And I think at the end of the day, each case is an individual case. And as long as you know how to take care of the animal properly, and you're giving it the right environment, you're treating it with respect and love like you should do anyway, then that's halfway there. If it could be rehabilitated back to wherever it came from, perfect too. But it's not always the case. I mean, there are many animals bred in captivity that don't know anything different, so you would not be able to put that animal back into the wild without a lot of rehabilitation. So situations like that, I certainly wouldn't expect somebody to take a wild animal from Africa and then put it in their home. So most of the exotic animals you see in the UAE are usually bred in the UAE. And if you understand that, okay, I've got a crocodile or an alligator, my guy, and you have to learn what that animal needs. If you can provide that environment at your home, then, you know, I don't see a big problem with it. But surely an animal that's wild should be better in the wild. But there's many arguments to, maybe it's an endangered species, if you leave it in the wild, it will die. Maybe if it's an endangered species in captivity, maybe it's got more chance of survival. So there's many different ways. It always depends on the species of animal as well and who's taking care of it.
في وايد ناس الحين قاموا يشترون هالحيوانات عشان بس مثلا يصورونهم حق انستغرام ولا سناب شات ولا اي برنامج حق يعني فتره قصيره عقب يعني يبيعونه ولا يعطونه اي حد. انا اقول دام اذا انت تبغى تسوي شيء يعني يصير حديقة أي حيوان في أو في مثلاً حدائق مخصصة أو أماكن مخصصة يعني في حيوانات صغيرة تقدر تصور وياها وهذا فليش يعني تشتري وعقب تبيع وما تهتم وهذا فأنا أشوف هذا الاختيار الأحسن.
Don't keep these animals to showcase them to other people. We keep them because the reserves were overpopulated, so we're taking a load off the reserves. We plan on selling them in the future to other people for breeding purposes.
It's hard because you have animals from different countries, you have animals from South America. We don't have rainforest environment here, and also it's too hot. You have animals from North America. They need the AC all year round. You have ferrets, skunk. These all need AC. They don't survive in this weather. So. Surely it would be better for these animals to be back where they came from, in a better environment. To have animals like this that are brought into this country for sale, it's a business at the end of the day. All animal trading is a business. So we have a lot of animals that are in the AC, say 6, 7, 8 months of the year. And when the cooler months are there, they're nice and happy outside. We have rabbits, guinea pigs, hamsters, all these animals, the smaller animals. We have one skunk there in the farm as well. He's now inside. We have some kinkajous, which are nocturnal animals, but they're rainforest animals, maximum temperature 36. So they have to live inside most of the time, which is a shame. As if they're in the wild, they'd be quite happy swinging from the trees. So you can only do what you can for the animals that are in your environment where you live and try and make them as comfortable as they can, which is not always easy.
Now I'm the king of the swingers, oh, the jungle VIP. I've reached the top and had to stop, and that's what's bothering me.
Sure.
I wanna be a man cub, and stroll right into town, and be just like the other men. I'm tired of walking around, oh, ooby-doo. I wanna be like you. I wanna walk like you, talk like you, too. You see it's true. And they like me.
أمان خلاص أمان خلاص سير ألعب يا فلة سير ألعب يا فلة
لا تحصل عليها
إذا خلاص تمام.